सदाशिव समारंभां शंकराचार्य मध्यमां अस्मदाचार्य पर्यंतां वंदे गुरु परंपरां श्रुति स्मृति पुराणानामालयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। ॐ सहनावतु सहनौ नक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः। यो ब्रह्माण विदधाति पूर्वं वेदागश्च प्रणोति तस्मै तगुं हतेमात्मबुद्धिप्रकाशं मुक्षुर्वै शरणमहं प्रपद्ये। ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः। आम्नायन्ते संसिद्धम् आदिमध्यान्तवर्जितम् आनन्दघनम् आपूर्णम् आत्मज्योतिरुपास्महे। यू सी नि सूत्रार्थ 447। एवमपि उपन्यासात् पूर्वभावाद् अविरोधं बादरायणः। सो देर इज नो विरोध इफ यू कंसिडर बोथ दि पूर्वपक्षीज मत एंड see that the chinmatra swarupa of atma is not going to be having any issue to have prapancha also together, because both are at different satta levels. It is not contradictory to each other. So considering both of their opinions, putting them together is the badarayana mata. As to chinmatra swarupa is all right for a mukta, but still it is without any issue of the prapancha continuing in vyavaharika satta. Mithya, it is not tuchha. So the vritti says evam api paramarthika chaitanya matra swarupa abhyupagami api. Even if you take the fact as to the status of the mukta being chinmatra, chaitanya matra, mere consciousness, still there is no विरोधा टु पूर्वोक्त उपन्यासादिभ्यः। सो पूर्वोक्त उपन्यासात् विरोधः नास्ति। हियर ऑल दि हेतुज आर कंसिडर्ड बाय दि वृत्ति। नॉट ओनली वन हेतु, दि विधि एंड व्यपदेश ऑल्सो कैन बी कंसिडर्ड एंड देर इज नो विरोध देर। पूर्वभावात् विरोध नास्ति। पूर्वस्य ब्रह्मस्वरूपस्य सर्वज्ञत्वादेः व्यावहारिकस्य भावात् ब्रह्मणः मुक्तात्मनः सप्रपंचत्व निष्प्रपंचत्वयोः अविरोधं बादरायणः आचार्यो मन्यते इत्यर्थः। सो बादरायण आचार्य कंसीडर्स दैट देयर इज नो विरोध। ओके, सो देयर इज नो विरोध विद दि अर्लियर हेतुस गिवन एज टू पूर्वस्य ब्रह्मस्वरूपस्य। द ब्रह्मस्वरूप इज विथ सर्वज्ञत्वादि सर्वसंकल्पत्वादि गुणास् and those are vyavaharika gunas. They are mithya, they are not having the same level of satta as satchit ananda chaitanya. Therefore their being there, meaning the sarvajnyatvadi being there at the same level of reality as earlier, which is mithya vyavaharika, and that vyavaharika satta can still continue. It has the same continuing satta. The satta of prapancha is not going to change. Therefore, sarvajnyatvadi Ishvara gunas can continue to be there. In Brahma, there is no virodha with paramarthika sat, which is Chaitanya. And thereby, Brahmana muktatmana, this Brahma rupa muktatma, atma swarupa is Brahma, so mukta is remaining in that paramarthika swarupa. Thereby, saprapanchatva nishprapanchatva yoha avirodham badarayana acharya manyate charta. Badarayana acharya considers that there is no virodha with the saprapanchatva, which is this mukta along with prapancha continuing, which is vyavaharika, and nishprapanchatva because from paramarthika drishti there was never a prapancha. So that prapancha continues in the mithya satta. There is no virodha with this paramarthika satta. Nishprapanchatva is fact, whereas saprapanchatva is at a vyavaharika level, mithya level. Avidyaka dharmanam सर्वज्ञत्वादीनाम उपपत्तेः न तेषां तुच्छत्वमिति भावः। सो आविद्यक धर्मस, आविद्यक अविद्याकृत सर्वज्ञत्वादि धर्मस आर मिथ्या, एंड देयर बाय देयर इज नो भेदा देयर, मीनिंग देर इज नो रियल भेद. सो सर्वज्ञत्वादिना उपपत्ते दि आविद्यक अविद्याकृत गुण शैल कैन स्टिल कंटिन्यू. दि मुक्त डज नॉट हैव अविद्या बट अविद्याकृत आर देर फॉर अदर्स. इफ यू कंसिडर देर आर अदर्स जीवांतर दैट वॉज अनदर पक्ष गिवेन. पूर्व पक्ष हैड सेड दैट फ्रॉम दि पर्सपेक्टिव ऑफ वी हैड सीन दैट फ्रॉम दि पर्सपेक्टिव ऑफ जीवांतर व्यवहार दृष्ट्या. सो टू दैट सिद्धांत ही सेड देर इज नो इश्यू देर. फ्रॉम दि पर्सपेक्टिव ऑफ अदर्स दि प्रपंच इज कंटिन्यूइंग. सो फॉर देम लेट देर बी व्यावहारिक सत्ता ऑफ दि सर्वज्ञत्वादि गुणाज ऑल्सो इन परमात्मा एंड दे सी दैट दिस दिस ज्ञानी गुरु हैज बिकम दैट परमात्मा. सो सर्वज्ञत्वादि गुणाज लेट देम बी इन परमात्मा. देर इज व्यावहारिक सत्ता मिथ्या सत्ता फॉर दोज गुणाज. So that is the seventh sutra and the adhikarana is over there by. The next adhikarana is sankalpa adhikaranam. So now the inquiry is into this mukta who has attained brahmaloka. Brahmaloka vasi, he is continuing to be saguna brahma upasaka. He is continuing to be in brahmaloka as long as the kalpa does not end. Brahmaloka will be there and he will also continue to be there in that brahmaloka. So now what is the phala to this brahmaloka vasi saguna brahma upasaka reaching brahmaloka was one phala. Having reached brahmaloka, what is his vasa? What is he supposed to get there? Just reaching brahmaloka, he has a very long vasa. So what is the quality of life, so to say, there? So to that, there are with respect to that, there are many question that come up. So here the sankalpadikarana discusses this. Purvatra brahmani vishesha asambhavat avishesha pravruttapi savishesha shrutihi aupadhika vishaya iti vyavasthapita. So purvapakshi says that what is that the siddhanti has done. Brahmani vishesha asambhavat, nirguna brahma is nirvishesha brahma, there cannot be any vishesha in brahma. And thereby avishesha pravrutta api shruti. This avishesha shruti, which is actually what avishesha pravrutta. Since there cannot be vishesha, savishesha, brahma is not savishesha, brahma is nirvishesha vastuta. Then what about this savishesha shruti? Savishesha shruti is aupadhika vishaya. It is savishesha brahma is discussed with the upadhi in mind. The prapancha is an upadhi, shrashtutva is an upadhi, sarvajnyatva is an upadhi. So all the shruti where brahma visheshas are talked about, they are all avishesha pravrutta shruti only. So even if it is avishesha pravrutta, it is to land the jiva sadhaka into the nirvisheshatva via savishesha. Still the savishesha shruti is also valid. How is it valid? Considering upadhi. Although nirvishesha is the real truth where the sadhaka is led by the shruti, savishesha shruti does not have to vanish. It will still continue to be with the upadhi in mind. As long as upadhi drishti is there, or whoever has the upadhi drishti, whether it is satya or mithya for an ajnani or a sadhaka, so long the prapancha has to be given some validity. Whether it is vyavaharika or mithya, it is not tuchha. But upadhi is considered there, and that is how the Siddhanti ascertained the Shruti having Savishesha and Nirvishesha also. Nirvishesha is the real Sat, whereas Savishesha is Upadhika Vishaya Vyavasthapita. This is how the Siddhanti has established the Shruti without any contradiction between the two varieties of Shruti. Na Tatha Iha. The counter example. So pratyudharana sangati na tatayya. Purva pakshi brings up a context where this kind of an arrangement is not possible. So he says na tatayya avishesha pravruttam anumanam. The shruti which was avishesha pravrutta, that you can explain, although it was avishesha pravrutta, savishesha shruti was explained as aupadhiki, aupadhika vishaya. Here you can't do that. Where avishesha pravruttam anumanam, the anumana is to explain the nirvishesha, avishesha pravrutta. That anumana अयोगी विषये व्यवस्थापनीयम् न तथा व्यवस्थापनीयम्। सो यू कैनॉट से दैट इज अयोगी विषय, इट इज नॉट योगी विषय। दिस इज अ क्लेम दैट वॉज आई मीन दैट इज अ क्लेम दैट विल बी ब्रॉट अप एंड पूर्व पक्षी इज सेइंग यू कैनॉट डू दैट, इन दिस केस यू कैनॉट डू। सो द संकल्प वेर यू नो द कॉन्टेक्स्ट इज वेर इन द ब्रह्मलोक दिस उपासक सगुण उपासक हैज रीच देयर। नाउ इट इज सेड दैट जस्ट बाय मियर संकल्प पितृलोक कामो भवति। सो हिज पितृगणास आर हिज एंसेस्टर्स आर अवेलेबल टू हिम इवन इफ ही डज अ मियर संकल्प। सो देयर बाय अविशेष प्रवृत्तम अनुमानम अयोगी विषये व्यवस्थापनीयम न व्यवस्थापनीय न विल गो देयर। सो यू कैन नॉट से इट इज एप्लीकेबल फॉर नॉन योगीज, मीनिंग यू हैव टू हैव सम सिद्धि। जस्ट बिकॉज यू हैव रीच्ड ब्रह्मलोक यू इट इज नॉट दैट जस्ट बाय मियर संकल्प यू विल गेट पितृयोग, मीनिंग द पितराज विल अपियर, पितृगणा विल अपियर, इट इज नॉट ट्रू सेज द पूर्व पक्षी। He says that only for yogis it is applicable. So it is not ayogi vishaya, it is yogi vishaya. This is the purva paksha. Yoginyapi sankalpa atirikta sadhana sambhavad iti pratyudarana sangatya idamaha. And he says that with respect to yogis also, mere sankalpa is not sufficient. So even with respect to yogis, you see that they have to have siddhi where other sadhana is needed. Just by you know, dharana, dhyana, samadhi, you don't really get all kinds of siddhis. So there is a vibhuti pada which talks about other than kaivalya, there is a lot of phala mentioned there. So other atirta sadhana, sankalpa atirta, just by mere sankalpa they don't get, they have to do something else also. Even with this vibhuti also when you attain, something else has to be done for that vibhuti to fructify. And thereby, pratyudarana sangatya, idamaha. This becomes a counter example to the earlier adhikarana's conclusion as to both can be seen together, meaning you can have savishesha nirvishesha together without contradiction. But here there will be a contradiction, you cannot explain the shruti without the anya sadhana, meaning you cannot take shruti literally. There will be a lot of contradiction as per the Purva Pakshi, and thereby Sankalpa Adhikaranam has come up, where the Sutrakara says Sankalpa Devatu Tachrutehe, Sankalpa Devatu Tachrutehe. So Pitradi Vibhuti Praptihi Sankalpa Deva. Why? Two is to counter the Purva Paksha. Why? Tachrutehe, because the Shruti is there. Shruti itself says so. What is the problem in accepting that? You don't know what happens in Brahmaloka, says the Siddhanti to Purva Pakshi. You don't even know that there is Brahmaloka. Brahmaloka is revealed by the Shruti. Sadhana to reach Brahmaloka is revealed by the Shruti. The phala in the marga is revealed by the Shruti. The Amanava Purusha who takes the Upasaka, who is Apratika Upasaka to Brahmaloka, that is revealed by the Shruti. Whatever sankalpa he does, he gets the phala in Brahmaloka, that is also revealed by the Shruti. What is your problem? Why do you compare it with Loka and other yogis? Says the Siddhanti. So, Tachruti, because such Shruti exists, you have to accept it as it is. There is no other pramana to counter it. There is absolutely no pramana. Shruti says this. When is it going to be considered as an arthavada? When you have some other pramana which is countering, there is no such pramana. You have no pramana for Brahmaloka or Brahmaloka Vasi or their sankalpas or their vibhutis. And it is absolutely causing no issue with anything else. Meaning, to accept it as a fact, there is no issue. It is not illogical. Thereby, that is the sutrartha, meaning it is in the literal sense, is the सिद्धांती। अत्र पूर्वपक्षे लोक वृत्तानुसरणं फलम् सिद्धांती तु विद्याबलेन संकल्पस्येव भोग पुष्टिकरत्व सिद्धिः फलम् इति विवेकः। सो पूर्वपक्षी सेज मंडे व्हाट क्लास ओके ओके सो अत्र पूर्वपक्षे लोकवृत्तानुसरणं फलम् देयर इज फल विच शुड बी इन कीपिंग विथ लोकवृत्त 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 इज वॉट एवर यू सी इन दि वर्ल्ड सिमिलर शुड बी दि फल एल्सवेयर ऑल्सो दैट इज नॉट ट्रू सेज सिद्धांति सो सिद्धांति से सिद्धांति तो विद्याबलेन बिकॉज ऑफ विद्याबल उपासना बल संकल्प इट्सेल्फ विल गिव दिस विभूति सो संकल्पस्य एव भोग पुष्टिकरत्व सिद्धि व्हाटएवर भोगा दि उपासक वांट्स इन ब्रह्मलोक ही विल गेट दैट भोगा दि संकल्प इट्सेल्फ विल स्ट्रेंथन दैट कामना इनटू भोगा सो भोगा विल बी अटेन्ड जस्ट बाय दि संकल्प वाय विद्याबलेन बिकॉज ही हैज ऑलरेडी डन उपासना He may not have had that phala in the on Prithvi Loka, but in Brahma Loka, since he has succeeded in his sadhana, and the result of that is Brahma Loka prapti, whatever he desires, he'll get it there itself. It is true even in Swarga. Swarga also not a lot of effort is to be taken. That is what the phala is. Sukha is there. If you have to take as much effort as in the Loka, then what is the use of being in Swarga? So Brahma Loka. Swarga, Brahmaloka, all these have the phala where the sankalpa, not all sankalpas may fructify for Swarga Vasis, for Brahmaloka Vasi who has done upasana, for him there will be sankalpa teva siddhi. This is the difference between the two pakshas. Dahara vidyayam shruyate. In the Dahara Akasha, you see Brahma in that vidya upasana. What is it that we hear? Sayadi pitrloka kamo bhavati sankalpade vasya pitaras samuttishtanti iti. So this phala is not while being in the sharira. After the sharira, the upasana will give phala as to landing into brahmaloka. Then in brahmaloka, the rules of loka do not apply. Prithviloka do not apply. As to in prithviloka, he has to do some yoga sadhana, has to follow some other, Siddhi sadhaka sadhana, and then following that he'll get something. It is not true. So when yadi if at all this upasaka sa yadi if at all he becomes what bhavati pitruloka kama, he desires to have pitru loka anubhava or pitru anubhava, he wants to see his ancestors or have their anubhava, then sankalpa devasya pitra samuttishtanti. The ancestors themselves will appear to him without any effort. Iti tatra kim brahmalokastasya vidushaha sankalpadeva pitradi bhuti prapti uta yatnantara sahakrutat tasmad iti sandehe. So when the doubt is as to whether this brahmalokasta upasaka vidusha vidwan will attain this pitradi vibhuti, pitra is just an upalakshana. All that he desires, will he get that vibhuti immediately just by sankalpa, just by desiring it so? Or yatnantara sahakruta? Or is it along with some other prayatna, some other effort? Is other sadhana also involved? And due to that combination of his sankalpa and another effort, will he get the pitradi vibhuti? When such doubt comes up, vidusha sankalpaha yatnantara sapekshaha भोग सामग्री संकल्पत्वात् अस्मदादि संकल्पवत् इति अनुमानेन पूर्वपक्षी ब्रिंग्स अप एन अनुमान. व्हाट इज द अनुमान? ही सेज विदुष संकल्प यत्नांतर सापेक्षः. यत्नांतर इज अन्य अन्यः यत्नः यत्नांतरम्. अनदर प्रयत्न हैज टू बी डन. जस्ट संकल्प इज नॉट इनफ. संकल्प इज वन प्रयत्न. संकल्प मीन यू डिजायर, दैट इज वन प्रयत्न. आई वांट दिस. देन आफ्टर दैट व्हाट? सापेक्ष. देर इज अनदर अपेक्षा. अपेक्षया सह यत्नांतर इज अनदर अपेक्षा. अलॉन्ग विद दैट इज संकल्प. सो संकल्प इज व्हाट? यत्नांतर सापेक्षः. इट इज डिपेंडेंट ऑन another yatna, another sadhana, not just sankalpa, but sankalpa is dependent on more effort being taken by this vidwan. Why so? What is the hetu? In the anumana, the hetu is bhoga samagri sankalpatvat. Because sankalpa reaching bhoga needs a samagri also. So bhoga samagri sankalpatvat. His sankalpa is along with the bhoga samagri. Without that he cannot have the result of bhoga. Because bhoga, sankalpa of bhoga is with some samagri needed. When you desire some food, so asmadadi sankalpavaditi anumanin. This is the udharana there. Asmadadi sankalpavad. If you want to have some dish, you cannot just wish the dish. Imagine you tell, let's assume that your spouse is cooking, or your mother is cooking, or your daughter, or whoever, or you yourself are cooking. And then, but better example is when someone else is cooking. So it's easier to understand. So you ask someone, oh, I want to have this today. What does the person who is cooking say? Oh, good. Let's have it. But there is no samagri. So samagri apreksha is also there. If you want to have the cooked food, you better bring the ingredients. Then only will I cook. So this person who has a desire also has a desire of samagri. So bhoga samagri sankalpatvat. It is along with this bhoga samagri. And thereby asmadadi sankalpa, just like our sankalpa is with the samagri alone, you can get the end result, and sadhana has to be there for this vibhuti to fructify. Iti anumanne yatnantara sahakruta sankalpad vibhuti prapti riti purva paksha. So purva paksha says that it is along with another sadhana where you have to take an effort, a separate effort is needed, along with that this sankalpa will fructify. This vibhuti prapti will be there. Sankalpa vibhuti prapti is only with this additional effort of other sadhana. Whereas Siddhanti says it is not so, because Shruti is pramana there and it does not talk about any other samagri. Siddhantastu kevalat sankalpa deva asti vidusha pitradi vibhuti prapti. Mere sankalpa is sufficient. He wishes it, he gets it. That's it. Kutaha, why so? Tat shrute hai. Because Shruti is there, there is no additional samagri mentioned. Sankalpa devasya evakara is there. Sankalpa deva asya pitaras samuttishtanti. That evakara has to be understood in the literal sense. Evakara is there because you should not confuse that another effort is needed like other yogis, etc. Iti yatnantara nirapeksha satya sankalpa shruti. It is a satya sankalpa shruti. Although satya sankalpa word is not seen there, you see eva sankalpa deva shows that by mere sankalpa. Therefore, it is equivalent to Ishvara sankalpa, where he is satya sankalpa. Similarly, this upasaka who has attained brahmaloka, not this upasaka who is here, or not even the vidwan. This is the phala for the saguna brahma upasaka. Nirguna brahma upasaka who is here, or saguna brahma upasaka who has not yet got brahmaloka, or the nirguna brahma jnani also does not have this phala. Jnani cannot get this vibhuti. This vibhuti is very specific to the brahmaloka prapta, brahmalokastha upasaka. He has this phala. Therefore, he becomes satya sankalpa. Tayacha shrutya laukika anumana se bado drashtavya. So, laukika anumana is alright. In loka you can use this, but this is paraloka, this is brahmaloka where you have absolutely no anubhava at all. Says the Siddhanti to the Purva Pakshi, you have absolutely no other pramana countering it or establishing it also. You cannot have Ardha Jarate Nyaya or counter it by Laukika Anumana. The Brahmaloka Phala and the Brahmaloka Sankalpa Deva Vibhuti also, Vibhuti Prapti, has to be understood only by Shruti. Yadi Sankalpa Sadhanantara Sapikshaha. But if at all you insist that sankalpa has to be sadhanantara apeksha, meaning sapeksha, meaning it has to have dependency on another means to achieve this end result, a desire won't do, just desiring won't do, tarhi, then what will happen? Tarhi tadabhavi vidusha vandya sankalpatva satya sankalpatvam hi eta. This sankalpatva shruti would be countered and would have virodha, meaning you will be having virodha from the shruti. Shruti is a jeshta pramana here, and then vandya sankalpatvat. Because this, if the sankalpa of the vidwan upasaka vidwan is based on dependent on another sadhana, then he won't be satya sankalpa. He would be what? Vandya sankalpa. He will have vandya sankalpatva, meaning he has sankalpa, but it does not fructify. It becomes vandya. It becomes useless. So desiring is fruitless there. That is what will be contradictory to satya sankalpatva. Therefore, sankalpa anuguna sadhanantaram to ishtam eva itya dosha. You have to say that it is literal. Meaning sankalpa deva is literal, meaning only sankalpa is sufficient for this saguna brahma upasaka who has reached brahma loka. Now if at all the bhoga samagri sankalpatvat hetu, in that if we read that samagri sankalpa is also there, samagri would be sadhana, anya sadhana. So if at all another sadhana apeksha is there for the brahma lokastha upasaka, then let it be so. That is ishtapatti, says the siddhanti. So he says sankalpa anuguna sadhanantaram tu ishtam eva iti adoshah. If at all another sadhana is also desired by, no, let me go there, I don't want pitrus to come here, I want to actually go there, then another sadhana is needed to reach there. So some kind of reach, if he has some apeksha of sadhana which is in his own sankalpa, then that is ishta. Let him desire the sadhana also then. And if he desires sadhana, sadhana also will fructify. If he wants to travel by some means, that travel also will fructify in that very means. So not only the sadhya, but the sadhana also, if he desires, he'll get that. That is the satya sankalpattva. And sadhana apeksha, if it is there, he'll have such apeksha as well. In the sankalpa itself, he'll have this apeksha. Because even in loka also, when you make a sankalpa, we can say that I want this result only by this means. This is how I want it. By sadhu means you want something, not by asadhu means. So similarly, let there be sadhana sankalpa also, and that is ishta. Kincha, moreover what? Ataeva chananyadhipatihi. Ataeva chananyadhipatihi. And therefore alone, says the siddhanti with another sutra, ataeva cha. Ataeva cha means, and also, due to this reason alone, what is the end result? Ananyadhipati. So, ataeva cha ananyadhipati. Ananyadhipati is a single word. What does it mean? Anyaha adhipati nasti asya. So, there is no other ruler to this vidwan, meaning he is not going to pray to Ishwara to get the result. He is his own adhipati. There is no other adhipati. Vidushaha anyaha adhipati nasti. Therefore, what? He is ananya adhipati. Elsewhere in Shruti, in Upanishad, there is a word, I think in Brihat, there is a word as to anya raja. So, anya rajanaha, shabda is there, anya rajanaha. So, those who pray to devatas for I want this, I want that, they are or anya raja. Anya raja naha, meaning for them there is another ruler. But jnani does not have another ruler. He does not see Paramatma as separate from himself. He has nothing to ask for. He is a vairagi. He does not want anything from Paramatma. So he is not anya raj, anya rat. He is not someone who has a different ruler. He is his own ruler, meaning there is no ruler other than, there is no king separate, there is no superior to him, because he is the only existent entity. So similar is the case here for the upasaka, where he himself can get his own desired vishaya by sankalpa. Why would he pray? Therefore, he is not anya adhipati, he is ananya adhipati. So ataeva, because what is that ataeva? Due to this very karana. What karana? Satya sankalpatvadeva. Because he is satya sankalpa. See, imagine this. If you get whatever you want, why would, you know, imagine the kid. Kid gets anything and everything that he wants, be it from his parents. Assume that the kid gets anything and everything when he wants. Parents give him. Would he go and start earning, I want to get this, or ask his uncle and, you know, other relatives that I want this, my parents are not giving? He'll not. So similarly, this upasaka, whatever he wants, he gets immediately. सो वाई वुड ही प्रे और आस्क अदर्स इवन परमात्मा. सो सत्य संकल्पत्वाद हेतो एव विद्वान अनन्याधिपति ही भवति. ही बिकम्स अनन्याधिपति. ही हैज नो अधिपति, नो अदर रूलर. यदि विदुषा कश्चित अधिपति स्यात् तर्हि तदधीन भोगस्य संकल्प मात्र साध्यत्वाभावात् सत्य संकल्पत्व न स्यात्. इफ एट एंड अदर वे ऑल्सो इट इज ट्रू. इफ एट ऑल दिस विद्वान हैड अनदर अधिपति, अनदर रूलर, देन वॉट एवर ही वॉन्ट्स ही विल हैव टू आस्क, यू नो, कैन आई गेट दिस, कैन आई गेट दैट, आई वॉन्ट दिस प्लीज. सो ही कुड प्रे. सो देन तर्हि तद अधीन भोगस्य, द भोग वुड बी तद अधीन, मीनिंग अन्य अधिपति भोग अधीन. सो अन्य अधिपति अधीन. फॉर एग्जाम्पल फॉर अस वी आर ऑल ईश्वराधीन, और भोग इज ऑल ईश्वराधीन. इफ ईश्वर गिव्स देन ओनली वी कैन हैव भोग. वी कैन विश. सो पीपल से यू कैन विश, यू वॉन्ट गेट इट. सो यू कैन विश बट इट विल डिपेंड ऑन भगवान वेदर और नॉट यू गेट दिस भोग. सो वी हैव टू प्रे. सो तदधीन भोगस्य संकल्प मात्र साध्यत्व अभावाद. सो जस्ट बाय मेकिंग संकल्प वी डोंट गेट इट. ईश्वर हैज टू अप्रूव दैट. जस्ट लाइक बॉस हैज टू अप्रूव द एक्सपेंसिस, यू जस्ट कांट स्पेंड द मनी जस्ट बिकॉज इट इज देयर. सो यू हैव टू गेट अप्रूवल. सिमिलरली हियर संकल्प मात्र साध्य, वॉट एवर इज अटेनेबल बाय मियर संकल्प, दैट इज नॉट द केस अभावात. वाई? बिकॉज तदधीन भोगस्य, ईश्वराधीन इज द भोग, और अन्य अधिपति अधीन इज द भोग. Then सत्य संकल्पत्व न स्यात्. सत्य संकल्पत्व वुडंट हैव बीन द केस. एंड श्रुति टॉक्स अबाउट सत्य संकल्पत्वम. तस्मात् ब्रह्मात्मकस्य विदुषः, दिस विद्वान इज वन विथ परब्रह्म. सो परब्रह्म शक्तिज आर हिज ओन शक्तिज. ही कैन यूज देम, नॉट ऑल बट फॉर द मोस्ट पार्ट. सो इट विल बी सेड लेटर एज एक्सेप्ट फॉर दिस क्रिएशन एटसेट्रा विच इज ओनली विथ परमात्मा. Everything else samanya is available. That is why, you know, you make the you pray to the guru. In fact, in Tattva Bodha also, in Phalashruti, in the end it is said that those who pray the jnani or this upasaka also in this case, they get punya. Because the jnani sharira is not mere sharira. That's why it is retained also after the drop of the body. Sannyasi sharira is retained because it is a vibhuti. Ishvara himself is manifest there. Although Ishvara himself has entered everyone as as Jiva, Jiva Rupena, still in the Avatara Purushas it is clear, very clear. In the Parabrahma Tattva Jnani, in that person also the Sharira is not mere Sharira anymore. It is seen as a Vibhuti. Bhagavan himself is manifest there. Therefore, samadhi is made and then anyone can pray and get whatever one wants. As if one is praying to Paramatma, one can pray to the samadhi also. This is his sampradaya. So, tasmat brahmatmakasya vidusha. This vidwan who is brahma swarupa, brahma atma swarupam yasya vidushaha, sa vidwan brahmatmakaha. And then tasya brahmatmakasya vidusha. Shashti. संकल्पादेव फॉर दिस विद्वान हूज स्वरूप इज ब्रह्म परमात्मा इट्सेल्फ देन संकल्पादेव सर्वैश्वर्य प्राप्ति इति सिद्धम. इट इज एस्टैब्लिश दैट बाय मियर संकल्प ही अटेन्स दी फल. संकल्प कम्स टू लाइफ इमीडिएटली विदाउट एनी अदर एफर्ट और विदाउट एनी डिपेंडेंसी ऑन एनीवन एल्स. द नेक्स्ट अधिकरण इज अभावाधिकरण. पूर्वाधिकरण दृष्टांत संगत्ये दिमाह. एक्सटेंडिंग द एग्जाम्पल फ्रॉम द अर्लियर अधिकरण, द नेक्स्ट अधिकरण इज अभावाधिकरण. अभावं बादरीराह ह्येवम्, अभावं बादरीराह ह्येवम्. वी लुक एट द पूर्वपक्ष ऑफ अस. अत्र पूर्वपक्षे विशेषण श्रुते अनेकधा भाव श्रुतेर्वा मुख्यार्थत्व सिद्धिः. सिद्धांति द्वयोरपि श्रुत्योः विदुषः सत्यसंकल्पत्वादेव मुख्यार्थत्व सिद्धिरिति फल भेद. सो पूर्व पक्षी सेज दैट विशेषण श्रुति और अनेकधा भाव श्रुति. सो देर आर टू डिफरेंट श्रुतिज वेर सम विशेषण विशेषाज आर मेन्शंड अबाउट द उपासक. एंड देर इज अनदर श्रुति एज टू ही अनेकधा होती एकधा होती. ही कैन बिकम यू नो रिमेन वन और कैन बिकम मेनी फोल्ड. सो ही कैन टेक मल्टीपल शरीराज ऑल्सो. So there are such shrutis available. Now the Siddhanti, not the Siddhanti, Purvapakshi. So Purvapakshi Badari is considered as Purvapakshi here in this case. Earlier you have seen Badari and Badarayana Matas are same, but somewhere Badari and Badarayana Matas are different. Their Sharira Indriyanam Abhavam Badarihi. Now this Visheshana Shruti is there, Aneka Abhava Shruti, Aneka Dha Bhava, being manifold also. There are such Shrutis. So now, Vidhi Sankalpa. That Vidhi Sankalpa, when the Sankalpa comes to life immediately, is it with or without the Sharira Indriya? This is the question there. As to whether the Sankalpa of the Brahmaloka Prapta Upasaka coming to life, is it due to Sharira and Indriya being there along with Sharira or without the Sharira also? So the Purvapakshi Badari Raha Hyevam. What does he say? Abhav. There is no need for Sharira or Indriya. So Visheshana Shrute Anekada Bhava Shruteva Mukhyar Tattva Siddhi. It is in the literal sense, says the Badri Acharya. He says that let it be so. Meaning Sharira Indriyanam Abhavam. There is no Sharira or Indriya needed for the Sankalpa Siddhi. Hi Evam. And Adri Aha Hi Evam. And he says Shruti Hi Aha. Shruti says so. Evam. In this manner, Shruti says so. This is the Badari Paksha, it is the Purva Paksha. So, Atra Purva Paksha Visheshana Shrute Anekadha Bhava Shruterva Mukhyar Tattva Siddhi. So, whatever is mentioned in the Shruti there as Phala for the Brahma Lokastha, there nothing else is mentioned. So, Sharira Indriya are not needed. No mention is there of some Sharira or some additional Indriyas. So, let it be with mere Sankalpa, which was explained earlier. Therefore, it is an extension, Drishtanta Sangati. Siddhanti Dvayoropi Shrutyoho Vidusha Satya Sankalpatvadeva Mukhyartattva Siddhirti Phalabheda. So, both Shrutis, where Vishesha is talked about, meaning what is the Vishesha? With the Manas, etc. Along with Manas, along with Indriya, some Shruti talks about Visheshas. And another Shruti says, Anekada Bhava Shruti talks about, becomes manifold. So, when it becomes manifold, Shariras are there. Visheshana Shruti, Manas is talked about, Indriyas are not talked about, Sharira is not talked about. Therefore, Visheshana Shruti can be seen as without any, there is Visheshana mention of Manas, Manasa Etan Kaman Pashyan Ramate Ityadi is Visheshana Shruti. And then, Ekada Bhoti, Anekada Bhoti can also be other Shruti, where Anekada Bhava Shruti, that can be taken as Anekada Bhava Shruti. So there are aneka shariras, aneka dhavat means many shariras are there. So shariras are there, so shariras will have indriyas. But there are shruti vakyas where sankalpa deva, whether that sankalpa deva should be read with visheshana shruti or aneka dhavava shruti. So the aneka dhavava shruti mukhyartattva siddhi, meaning manas is mentioned, it is okay, manas, let there be manas. Sharira is not mentioned at all. Aneka dhavava also can be read in two ways. Whether aneka dhavava means multiple shariras, the bhoga of multiple shariras is there for the Brahmalokastha Vasi Upasaka. Now sharira is not mentioned for him, for the Brahmalokastha. So therefore Mukhyartattva Siddhi, Badari Acharya says that there is no sharira indriya needed. He may be connected with other shariras, but he does not have a sharira. He is in Brahmaloka. He has nothing to do with the other shariras. Bhogas are prapta without the sharira. Siddhanti Dvayorapi, both can be, you can read both any which way and still it does not have any issue with the Sankalpa Bhanga of the Upasaka. Because if Upasaka makes a Sankalpa of Sharira, let him have Sharira. If he makes a Sankalpa of multiple Shariras and Indriya, let him have that kind of a phala. If he makes Sankalpa that let me have Bhoga only via Manas, let me not have Indriyas and Sharira, let him have that Bhoga. So Siddhanti says that Dvayorapi, however you consider with one Dvayorapi, we can take as Jaimini Acharya and Badari Acharya, whatever they say, both can be clubbed together the way we saw earlier also, that both Purvapakshi Mata can be taken in account without any contradiction, because there were different level of realities earlier. Now what is being said is sankalpa, whatever is the sankalpa, that is going to be satya sankalpa. He is satya sankalpa, so that sankalpa is going to come true. If he desires a sharira, there will be a sharira. If he does not desire sharira, then there will be no sharira. So there is no issue with interpreting it in either way. So siddhante dvayorapi shrutyoho vidusha satya sankalpatvade mukhyartatva siddhiriti phalabheda. So just sankalpa matra siddhi has been mentioned. What sankalpa he should do, whether he should have indriyas or not, that is not talked about. Due to that, Badari Acharya is saying that there should be no indriya. Whereas Jaimini Acharya is saying that there will be indriya and sharira. And we say, Siddhanti Badarana Acharya says, we say that the way is the sankalpa, such is the bhoga. So there is no harm in Vidwan taking up multiple shariras or not taking up shariras and indriyas. Both ways it is okay. So Dvayorapi Shrutya means in both pakshas of the Shruti, both Shrutis are talking about and validating only Satya Sankalpatvam. Whether Indriya is there or not is not really the focus. The focus is Sankalpa Eva. So Sankalpa Deviti Shrutya Vidushastavat Manaha Asti Iti Avagatam. Because Sankalpa is done with the mind, only mind is ascertained for the Vidwan. Because without the mind you cannot make a Sankalpa. Manasika Sankalpa needs the mind. Without that there cannot be Sankalpa. And for this very reason, what do we say? Nirguna Brahma cannot be the creator because Maya is his Manas. That is needed, we infer Maya. Kim tasya sharirendriyani na santi uta santi, ahosvit santi na santi chaiti samshaye. So one paksha is, does he have sharira and indriyas or not? Does he not have sharira is one paksha. Second paksha is, no, does he have sharira? Third is what? Ahosvit santi cha? Santi nasanti chaiti samshe. Oh, he can have, he may not have. Both are possible. This is the third paksha. Yatha sankalpadeva ityavadharana shrutya sadhanantara bhava uktaha. Just like this Siddhanti has ascertained that the sankalpa shruti is literal, satya sankalpatvam is the meaning. So no other sadhana is needed. Then similarly, evam badari acharya. Badari acharya says similar is the case here. Sharira indriyanam abhava manyate. Why? Sharira indriyas are separate sadhanas. And sankalpad eva has been mentioned, which you, Siddhanti, have established. Therefore, sankalpa is the only sadhana. There is no other sadhana. Sankalpa itself will fructify. No sharira, no indriya are needed. Ahi evam. And ahi evam, Shruti says, abhavam amnayaha manasayitan kaman pashyan ramate jayete brahmaloke iti. This is what the Shruti says. Abhavam amnayaha. The Shruti itself says so. Says Badri Acharya. So he says that there is Ahahyevam. Just give me one moment. Let me cross check something. Ahahyevam. Okay. So Amna, it is right. So Amnaya Abhavam Evam Abhavam Amnaya Ah. So that's how you do the Anvaya and say, this is what the Shruti says. What is a manasa etan? Manas alone is mentioned. So etan kaman pashyan ramate. One rejoices seeing all these glories, all these desired vastus through the mind. With the mind alone, there is nothing else needed. Sankalpa is made with the mind and Ramana is also with the mind. Ya ete brahmaloke. Who are these? These who are Upasakas who have reached Brahmaloka, who are in Brahmaloka. Iti. So in Brahmaloka, there itself with Sankalpa, they'll achieve everything with the mind itself. Yadi vidusha shariradikam syat, tada manasa iti visheshanam, anya yoga vyavachedakam anarthakam syat ityeka purva paksha. So manasa, that is a visheshana. So visheshana Shruti talks about manas. Manas is a visheshana there. So that visheshana, if the sharira is there, sharira, when you talk about sharira, indriya and manas are included. So if sharira and indriyas are talked about, then why would it say manasa eva? The Shruti wouldn't say manasa itan. Manasa, not manasa eva, manasa etan. So manas Shruti is irrelevant there, would be irrelevant, says Badri Acharya. He says that visheshana in the visheshana Shruti, this is what he calls the visheshana Shruti. So visheshanam anya yoga vyavachedakam, anya yoga, manas being a visheshana, it is showing that sharira indriya are not there. Otherwise that visheshana will be invalidated. So anya yoga, anya meaning sharira and indriya, yoga vyavachedaka, it is separating itself from this visheshana, is separating the kamas which are attained through sharira and indriya as those which are attained through manas. Thereby that manas, which is a vishesh, manasaitan is a visheshana shruti, that visheshana would be anarthaka, anarthakam syaiti ekah purvapaksha. This is one purvapaksha. What is the second purvapaksha? Second purvapaksha is bhavam jaiminir vikalpana mananat, bhavam jaiminir vikalpa mananat. So vikalpasya amananat, bhavam jaiminihi vikalpa amananat is a single shabda samasa. Vikalpasya amananat, he says that sharira indriyanam bhavam jaiminihi acharya manyate. Why? Because vikalpa amananat, vikalpa has been, what is the vikalpa? Ekada bhavati, tridha bhavati, anekada bhavati, iti vikalpa aman, vikalpasya amanna. There is a vikalpa which we see in the shruti, here in the shruti. Therefore Jaimini Acharya considers that vikalpa is, he can take one sharira, he can take three shariras, tridha bhavati, anekada bhavati, he can take multiple shariras. Therefore upasaka can take shariras, that is the vikalpa. Therefore bhava sharira and indriyas are there. Otherwise why would Shruti say that he'll become one, he can become three, he can become multiple? Therefore we have to consider that this Jaimini Acharya says that sharira indriyas are acceptable for this upasaka. There is more with evakara. Let me see I'll talk about it if we still if I see that it has some importance there. Sharira indriyana manasa eva bhavam sattvam jaiminihi acharyo manyate. Because this visheshanam anya yoga vyavachedakam, there is something else to be mentioned there. Because manasa iti, manasa is a visheshana red. So there is something, I'll revisit this, give me a moment. Let's look at this paksha first. So sharira indriyana manasa eva bhavam sattvam jaiminihi acharyo manyate. Jaimini Acharya considers that manasa eva bhavam, like the mind is present, similarly sharira and indriya are also present. Why so? Sa ekada bhavati, trita bhavati, ityadina vidusha anekada bhava vikalpa mananat. Because vikalpa, multiple options are given to the upasaka as a phala. So ekada bhavati, trita bhavati, he can become one also, he can become three also, more also, anekada. And this kind of a bheda is not possible without sharira. He is one upasaka, how will he become threefold? Ekada I can understand, he'll remain like that, but how will he become threefold without the sharira? Therefore Jaimini Acharya says nahi sharira bhedam vina, without the sharira bheda this eka upasaka cannot become many. So kadachid ekada bhavah kadachid anekada bhava na sambhavati iti apara purvapaksha. The second purvapaksha where he says that this ekada tridha shruti, anekada shruti, where it gives vikalpa, multiple sharira possibilities, sometimes he is single, sometimes he is associated with multiple and becomes manifold. How can he become manifold without any, sometimes remains one, sometimes becomes many, how is it possible without sharira? So kadachid ekada bhava kadachid anekada bhava, sometimes he remains one, sometimes he becomes many. It is not possible without sharira sambandha. So sharira bhedam vina, unless shariras are there, he cannot become many. To contrast this, there is a siddhanta. But before that, this evakara visheshana, there is something to be said as to how this evakara works. As to visheshana, how does it work? So this visheshana has been read as though evakara is there. So this evakara, when you hear evakara, evakara has different kinds of anvaya possible. So whether the visheshana has the evakara, vishesha has the evakara, or kriya has the evakara association, meaning anvaya, based on that this evakara is vyavartaka. It differentiates something from the other. What does it differentiate? सो अन्य योग व्यावर्तकम ही हैज सेड अन्य योग व्यवच्छेदकम अनर्थकम स्यात्. सो विशेषण इज अन्य योग व्यवच्छेदक. सो व्हेन यू से यू मे नॉट यूज एवकारा एंड से व्हाट ब्रिंग मी अ रेड फ्लावर. सो इफ देर आर येलो फ्लावर्स व्हाइट फ्लावर्स व्हेन यू से ब्रिंग मी रेड द अंडरस्टैंडिंग इज ब्रिंग मी ओनली अ रेड फ्लावर. इफ यू ब्रिंग व्हाइट और येलो द पर्सन इज गोइंग टू से आई डिडंट आस्क फॉर इट. सो आई आस्क फॉर अ रेड फ्लावर. सो विशेषण इज व्यावर्तक. सो एवकार मे नॉट बी देर मे और मे नॉट बी देर यू हैव टू रीड इट अनलेस अदरवाइज स्पेसिफाइड. सो एवकार मे और मे नॉट बी देर वेन यू विशेषण इज देर दैट इट सेल्फ इज लाइक सेइंग देर इज एवकार. सो देर आर एग्जाम्पल्स गिवन एज टू हाउ दिस विशेषण वर्क्स. सो विशेषण इज त्रिप्रकार इट इज थ्री फोल्ड. सो प्रकार त्रय देर आर थ्री प्रकार हाउ दिस एवकार विशेषण वर्क्स. सो वेन यू यूज एवकार दिस इज हाउ द विशेषण ऑल्सो वर्क्स. पार्थ एव धनुर्धर. सो देर इज अ विशेष देर बाय एवकार देर इज विशेषण. सिमिलरली विशेषण इज सीन एज विथ एवकार. सो पार्थ एव धनुर्धर वेन यू से पार्थ एव धनुर्धर देन वॉट इज दैट विशेषेण स अन्वय विच इज ए विशेष. विशेष देर इज अन्य योग व्यावर्तक मीनिंग देर आर नो अदर धनुर्धर ओनली पार्थ इज धनुर्धर. दैट्स हाउ इट मीन्स पार्थ एव धनुर्धर मीन्स देर आर नो अदर धनुर्धर ओनली पार्थ इज धनुर्धर. दैट वुड बी द मीनिंग. एंड वन यू वन इफ यू से शंक पांडुरेव. सो शंक पांडुरेव दी शंक कॉन्च इज वाइट इट इज वाइट एव हैज बीन रेड. वेर डज दैट एव गो देर. सो देन विशेषण स अन्वय. सो विशेषण विथ विशेषण देर विल बी अन्वय मीनिंग अयोग व्यावर्तकम मीनिंग शंख इज वाइट ओनली मीन्स वॉट इट इज अन्य अयोग मीनिंग देर आर नो वाइट नॉन वाइट शंकास. कॉन्शियस हैव टू बी वाइट. देर इज नथिंग कॉल्ड एज अ नॉन वाइट कॉन्च. सो इट इज अयोग व्यावर्तक. इट शोज दैट इट इज दी अदर पॉसिबिलिटीज इन देर. देन नीलम पद्म भवती. इफ यू से नीलम पद्म भवत्येव. सो भवत्येव विथ क्रिया वेन यू डू द अन्वय ऑफ एवकार नीलम पद्म भवती मीनिंग लोटस इज ब्लू बट हियर यू हैव यूज एवकार विद द क्रिया. सो भवत्येव मीनिंग वॉट अत्यंत अयोग व्यावर्तकम मीनिंग इट लैंड्स इन टू द मीनिंग नॉट लाइक ब्रिंग मी अ रेड फ्लावर. सो हियर क्रिया इफ यू डू अन्वय विद द क्रियापद देन इट विल मीन नीलम पद्म भवत्येव. Somebody is saying no, there are no blue lotuses. This evakara is with the kriya. It says no, definitely there are blue lotuses also. There is blue lotus also. So bhavati eva with the kriya. If you do evakara anvaya, then it will mean what? There is blue lotus also. There may be others. I don't disagree that there are no others, but blue also. There is lotus which are blue also. So this is how the evakara works. And what is the पूर्व पक्षी सिंह विशेषण अन्य योग व्यवच्छेदक अनर्थक स्यात्. अन्य योग व्यवच्छेदक इज बिकॉज ही हैज डन अन्वय ऑफ दी इज रीडिंग दिस विशेषण विद दी एवकार इज बीइंग रेड विद दी विशेष्य. देयरफॉर ही सेइंग मनसा इति विशेषण. दिस मनसा इति विशेषण शोज दैट ओनली विद दी माइंड. वेर अन्य योग व्यवच्छेद देर इज नो अदर पॉसिबिलिटी. देर नो शरीर योग देर नो इंद्रिय योग. देर इज ओनली मनस योग. देर फॉर मनसा एतान कामान पश्यन रमते. देर मनसा मनस विशेषण इज शोइंग दैट देर इज ओनली द माइंड नथिंग एल्स. सो अन्य व्यावर्तकम इज बाय अन्य योग व्यावर्तकम. इट शोज दैट द उपासक इज कनेक्टेड ओनली विद द माइंड. ही इज नॉट कनेक्टेड विद द शरीर और इंद्रिया. दिस इज हाउ दिस द विशेषण अन्य योग दैट इज द मीनिंग देर. ओके सिद्धांतस्तु. What is the Siddhanta then? These are two Purvapaksha. Ekaha Purvapaksha and Aparah Purvapaksha has been mentioned. So Badri Acharya says one as to Sharira Indriya not being there. And Jaimini Acharya, Aparah Purvapaksha, says that there is Sharira Indriya Yoga also. Siddhantastu Dvadashahavad Ubhayavidam Badrayanotaha. Dvadashahavad Ubhayavidam Badrayanotaha. So Dvadasha Ahavad. उभय विदम बादरायण अतः. So ataha hetu dvayat, the same hetus which have been given by Purvapakshis, two Purvapakshis, Siddhanti Badranacharya Manyate, he considers both these hetus. He puts them together and he says, since both possibilities exist, then they are not contrary to each other, let it be both. Why? Because based on Sankalpa, if the Sankalpa is with the Sharira and Indriyas, then the Upasaka will have Sharira Indriya. If the Sankalpa is with only the mind and he does not want Sharira Indriya, still wants Bhoga, he'll have the Sukshma Bhoga like Swapna. In Swapna, the Bhoga is without the Sharira and Indriya. There is no Jagras Sharira and Indriya there. There is Anya, in the mind one imagines some Sharira and some Indriyas. So such will be his Bhoga. If he wants Sharira Yoga and Indriya Yoga, then he'll have that also. There is no Virodha in that. There, why? The Udharana there is Dvadasha Ahavat. Ubhaya Vidya means with Sharira Indriya Sambandha, without Sharira Indriya Sambandha also. Why? Ataha, due to Hetu Dvaya mentioned by Purva Pakshis, Ubhaya Vidya, both possibilities are there. That is Badarayana's conclusion, Badarana Acharya Manyate. What is Udharana? Dvadasha Ahavad. So Dvadasha Ahavad, there is a Dvadashaha, Satra which goes on for 12 days. So some karma which goes for many days. Now where there are many karma which is done across many days. Now this yaga which is done across many days, if there are many yajmanas, then it is considered as satra. If there is only one yajmana, then it is considered ahina. Now this dvadasha aha that goes across 12 days, both kinds can go for 12 days, both will be called as dvadasha aha. There can be many yajmanas, there can be one yajmana also. If there are many yajmanas, then it will be called as satra. If there is a single yajmana, then it will be called as ahina. Where is the virodha? Both are dvadasha. So similarly, this sankalpadeva, he can attain Sharira Indriya Sambandha also, and without Sharira Indriya Sambandha also, the Upasaka can have Phala when he is in Brahmaloka. So, Atayeva, Manasa iti Visheshanad Anekadha Bhava Vikalpa Vidhana Cha. Both hetus given by both the Purvapakshas are put together. Visheshanad, due to Manasa iti Visheshanad, due to Manasa iti. So, Evakara can be read, only through the mind he'll have. Only through the mind he can have bhoga. That is one reading. And the second Purvapakshas reading is Anekadha Bhava Vikalpa Vidhanacha. And because Anekadha Bhavati Sharira Indriya Sambandha, there are many Shariras and Indriyas that he can take. Oh, he can take. We agree. Therefore, both possibilities are there. He needs no Sharira Indriya. He may want more Sharira and Indriyas. Evam Lingadvayat. That is the meaning of Ataha. Due to these two lingas which have been used by Purvapakshis, but showing contradiction, we are saying there is no contradiction. Yada Shariradi Sankalpa Tata Sharira Indriya Vattvam. Yada Tu Tat Sankalpa Abhava, meaning Sharira Indriya Sankalpa Abhava is there, Tata Sharira Indriya Vattva Abhava Iti Ubhayadva Vidham. So both types of Sankalpas are possible. When he makes a Sankalpa that let me have Sharira, when he does not have such Sankalpa, he wants only the mind to be the sadhana for bhoga, then he attains it through the mind alone. So sharirendriyatva abhava will be there when there is no such sankalpa. When there is a sankalpa of sharirendriya, he'll get that also. Iti ubhaya vidam vidusha aishwarye badra aishwaryam ubhaya vidam aishwaryam. There should be a dot here. So aishwaryam badrana acharya manyate. Let me cross check that whether it is Aishwaryam or should be Aishwaryam, but let me cross check anyway. Ubhaya Vidya Aishwaryam. So there is a Anuswara missing there. So Badarana Acharya Manyate. He considers that the Aishwarya of the Upasaka is in both ways. Whether he wants Sharira or no Sharira Indriyas, both are possible. Dvadasha Ahavat. Like the example in Karma Kanda, Yatha Dvadashaham Ruddhikamaha Upeyuhu Iti Upayi Chodana Gamyatva Dvadashahasya Satratvam. Since there is a Vidhi Vakya as to Upeyuhu, one should Ruddhikama. समृद्धि काम वन हु वांट्स समृद्धि फेम ही शुड डू द्वारशाह इति उपायी चोदना गम्यत्वात् सो हु इज दैट वन हु हैज दिस डज दिस हु शुड बी वृद्धि काम समृद्धि काम वृद्धि काम और समृद्धि काम सो वन हु वांट्स दैट इज एन उपायी सो ही वांट्स दैट सो द ही विल यूज दिस प्रयोग ऑफ सत्र ही विल डू दिस सत्र सत्र एंड दैट सत्र need not be desired only by one person there can be many who can come together and do that so upai chodana gamyatva dvadashas satratvam because many can be there therefore satratva also dvadashahena prajakam yajayet upeyuh is bahuvachana so upeyuh there upai chodana gamyatva upai can be many upeyuh says that many can do this so bahuvachana is there And there is also yajayet iti singular. So there is a singular also. So prajakamam dvadashahena yajayet. He should get this done. One yajmana. So many yajmanas can also be there. And single yajmana can also be there in this. So if it is multiple yajmanas, then it will be called a satra. Otherwise what? Iti aharganatve sati yajati chodana gamyatvad ahanitvam. It can become ahinatvam. It can become ahina. So it can become satra by many upeyuhu, many yajmanas or iti aharganatve sati, yajati chodana. So yajayet is yajati chodana. So there only singular is used, thereby yajmana aharganatve, it will go across 12 days of course. And even across 12 days, it is only a single yajmana. Therefore yajati chodana gamyatvad ahinatvam also. It can be, there can be satratvam also. By many yajmanas, there can be ahinatvam also by single yajmana. Thereby, gamyatvad ahinatvam cha iti ubhay vidatvam tadvad ityartha. Similarly, is the case of this brahmalokavasi who can be wanting sharira and indriyas, who may or may not want sharira. So, may be without sharira sambandha also, he'll have bhoga. With sharira sambandha also, he can have bhoga. With multiple shariras also and indriyas also. We'll continue in the next patha with the next sutra in the same adhikarana. Amna yantika samsiddham adhi madhyanta varjitam anandaghanam apurnam atma jyotirupasmahe. Namaste. Dhanyavada.
Dhanyavada. Namaste.